So what is the role of the gamma aminobutyric acid, so GABA? GABA is one of the most prominent inhibitory neurotransmitters. So generally, GABA is reducing the chance of neurons to get the action potential. It's reducing the chance that they would be activated. So, knowing this, how to remember it? Generally, GABA is, maybe another way, alcohol is strongly related to increased GABA. Yes, so generally, after alcohol, everything is decreased. Yes, all of our abilities are decreased. So pain, so coordination, pain also is decreased. The ability to think coherently, to speak coherently, to move coherently. Generally, everything is inhibited. Yes, of course. We have also some effects of the deinhibition, yes, so when some neurons that is normally inhibiting other neurons, yes, so what is the deinhibition, yes, we have neuron A, for example, and neuron B. When neuron A is working constantly to inhibit the neuron B, yes, it's a natural situation, yes, we have neuron A and neuron B, and normally, neuron A is all the time inhibiting neuron B. Yes, so neuron B has a hard time to get activated. Yes, and now we will get the GABA to the neuron A. What it would lead to? It would inhibit neuron A. So if we have inhibition of the neuron A, it will stop inhibiting neuron B. If neuron A would stop inhibiting neuron B would get activated. Yes. So one more time, what is the inhibition? We have neuron A and neuron B. Neuron A is inhibiting neuron B. Yes? So it when the neuron A fires, when the neuron A gets activated, its action is inhibition of the neuron B. So when we would use the GABA to inhibit neuron A, it would stop inhibiting neuron B, and neuron B would be able to pass the signals, yes? So, of course, because of it, it's not so clear-cut that administering substances that increase the GABA production would inhibit everything because of this disinhibition effect. However, in really, really a lot of cases, it would be true. So, GABA has a peripheral role in the pain transmission, similar to bimodal actions of acetylcholine. Receptors are on the unmyelinated preferent afferents. Yes, so of course, as told before, we need some receptors in order for the neurons to get the idea that such substance is around, and generally those receptors in case of the GABA are mainly in the synapses, yes, because the GABA is a neuron transmitter that is released mainly in the synapses. So, of course, we have a lot of the GABA-A receptors found in the DRG, so dynamic range cells, on the other central terminus in the dorsal horn. So, dorsal horn, we are thinking about the spinal cord. And direct application of GABA antagonists to the DRG cell decreases hypersensitivity in animal model neuropathic pain. Well, let's not delve too much detail. Okay. Thank you very much.